awesome. How many of you guys have been to Camp Luther before? Oh, awesome. Sweet. Well, I'm going to do my best to bring a little bit of camp to you today. We're going to sing some songs, watch a video, I'll have a message. So it's kind of a fun camp day. So we are going to start. If you would all please join me in prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the sunshine. Thank you for everyone here and getting us all here safely. Please let this chapel time just be honoring to you and help us to learn a bit more about you. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, so at Camp Luther, we start our days off with first word. And so that's what we're going to start today off with. So we're opening up the Bible right away. And so our first word today comes from Philippians chapter 3, and it says this: "But whatever were gains to me, I now consider loss for the sake of Christ. What is more, I consider everything a loss because of the surpassing worth of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord, for whose sake I have lost all things. I consider them garbage that I may gain Christ and be found in him, not having a righteousness of my own that comes from the law, but that which is through faith in Christ, the righteousness that comes from God on the basis of faith. I want to know Christ, yes, to know the power of his resurrection and participation in his sufferings, becoming like him in his death, and so somehow attaining to the resurrection from the dead." And so we'll come back to that in a little bit, so keep that in the back of your mind. Another thing that we love to do at Camp Luther is we love to sing. And so I have two Camp Luther classics for us this morning. The first one is I Am a Seed. And so there are some actions to this. Really, the actions are your goal is to make every letter that we spell with your body. So it can be sign language. If you know sign language, that's awesome. Or you can try to make it with your body right where you are. You don't need to touch your neighbor. But just right where you are, you can use your body to try and make the letter. So you guys can stand up. Again, you can stay right where you are. You don't need to get too close with your neighbor. Another crucial part of this song is to know that we're going to sing it a few times. But every time, we're going to get faster. So we're going to start out pretty, like, mediocre, probably, you know, kind of slow. But then we're going to sing it a few times. Each time, we're going to get faster. And so remember, you're trying to spell the letters. And so when we get to the end, it'll probably be fairly tricky to spell all the letters unless you're really good. But I'll give you a trick. It ends with L-L-Y. So if you miss everything else, you can go L-L-Y, and no one will know you didn't do the rest of it. They'll just think you're so cool because you got L-L-Y. So that's my tip for you. So we'll start out pretty slow.
And
for this is you'll have your rain, like raindrops come down, your fingers are raindrops, storm, like a storm cloud, fire, the flames are coming up, and wind, you just kind of throw it all away, wind. So rain, storm, fire, wind. There's some clapping in here, so you're going to go like, somebody's singing, Lord Kumbaya, clap, clap, somebody's singing, Lord Kumbaya, singing, rain, storm, fire, wind, Kumbaya, Lord Kumbaya, clap, clap, Kumbaya, Lord Kumbaya, clap, clap, and you repeat that. We're going to be changing, so you'll notice like dancing, laughing. So during that, you can do a little dance, or you can pretend to laugh, or whatever. Also, another, see, all these songs have a little trick to them. So the trick with this one is it adds just more fun to it if you're just singing normal, but then when we get to rain, storm, fire, wind, you're really loud for that part. So you're like, rain, storm, fire, wind, and then you just go back to singing normal. It makes it so much more fun.
So he grabbed all the rocks in his pockets and chucked them into the woods. started hissing. But even though he was absolutely terrified, he kept his eyes on the banana and he kept running right over the snake. Further on in the case, Tiggy ran straight into a thorny bush. Ouch! He thrashed in pain, and the more he thrashed, the more the thorns got stuck into his fur. Tiggy became trapped, unable to move without thorns poking him more and more, but he was just able to reach out one monkey arm and grab onto the banana. And the banana pulled Tiggy out of the thorn bush and back onto the path. Tiggy kept running across an icy cold river. He kept running past an ice cream stand that was giving away free ice cream. Tiggy kept running and running and running and running. His legs were tired. His arms were tired. Even his ears were tired. Tiggy began to run slower and slower and slower and slower until he didn't know if he could go one more step. But that's when Tiggy's mom and dad and all his family and all his friends leaped from behind a bush and started cheering him on. "Go, Tiggy, go," they screamed. "You can do it, Tiggy," they shouted. "We are right here with you, Tiggy," they yelled. And with his family and friends cheering him on, Tiggy kept his eyes fixed on the banana. And even though he was going really slow, he kept moving forward. Finally, Tiggy's legs could run no more. He fell flat on his face. It was smooshed on the ground. And with his face smooshed on the ground, he noticed something. It was the finish line. Tiggy had made it. He had finished the race. He had crossed the finish line. Tiggy was so happy. He leapt in the air. He shouted for joy. And then he ate the banana in a single bite.
Going right, so it's GPS, it's telling me, all right, 4 miles. And so I'm thinking,
all right, like around any corner now is going to be this waterfall. The waterfall didn't come. It was like 4.5 miles before we saw the waterfall. So something was wrong. But at about that 3.5 mile mark, I was tired. When we got to 4 miles, I thought, all right, this was coming soon. When it didn't come, I got a little cranky. I was tired and I just wanted to be there. And Psych had to remind me a couple times, we're going to see the waterfall. Remember, the waterfall's gonna be so cool. And then those people met us and they said, the waterfall's worth it. So I kept thinking, like, oh, I'm so tired, my back hurts, my legs hurt, but the waterfall's gonna be worth it. Oh, the waterfall's gonna be so cool. We got there, the waterfall was so cool. It was so tall, right? The tallest waterfall in the Smokies. We stayed there for a while, we had lunch there. So super cool. And then the walk back wasn't too bad because you're going down instead of up. So like Tiggy, right? Tiggy, he kept his eye on that banana. He kept thinking about that banana, even when the race got really hard. That was kind of like me when we were hiking, was I just kept thinking, all right, this waterfall's gonna be worth it. The waterfall's gonna be really cool. You can do this. The waterfall's gonna be really cool. There is a guy in the Bible, his name is Paul, and he actually wrote Philippians. So the book that we're talking about, he wrote it. And so Paul, he didn't have an easy life. He ran into some trouble. He was put in jail and he was beaten just because he believed in Jesus. And so he wrote these words it was kind of a rough day for him, right? So like Tiggy, he met a lot of obstacles, and I got tired hiking. Paul, he was it's kind of rough for him. He's in jail and everything, but he writes this. He writes, if you remember back to first word, he said, I consider everything garbage compared to knowing Christ. And here he says, I haven't made it yet. I haven't made it to the goal. I haven't made it to the finish line like Tiggy did. But I'm going to press on because Jesus is worth it. And so he keeps his eyes on Jesus. When life is hard for Paul, he says, yep, life is hard, but Jesus is going to be worth it. I haven't reached my goal yet, but I press on. And so that's what we can do. We keep our eyes on Christ when life gets hard, right? Because we know that life gets hard. People are mean to us. People get sick, you don't make the team, you get a bad grade, whatever it is, life is hard. But we keep our eyes on Jesus, and we keep that goal in mind. We keep eternal life with Jesus in mind, right? So Tiggy had the banana to look to, all right, that banana, it's hard right now with that banana. I have the waterfall. All right, I am tired and I am cranky, but this waterfall is going to be worth it. Paul and all of us have Jesus and life eternal with him to look forward to when life is hard. We can say, yep, this is hard, and Jesus is with us when it's hard. And we can know that waiting for us is eternal life. And that's why we press on. That's how we can press on. Because we remember that Jesus is with us and we're going to be with him forever one day. Would you guys please pray with me? Dear God, I thank you so much for your son, Jesus, and that you sent him to die for us and so we can have eternal life with you one day. I pray that you be with all of us. Help us to remember that you are always with us. Help us to remember when life is really hard, to look to you. Help us to go to you and remember that we have eternal life with you forever to look forward to, and help us to press on. I ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right, so we are going to talk now about summer at Camp Luther, because we are having summer camp this year and we are so excited. And so I have a video to show you and then we'll talk a bit more about it. Thank you. here, if you are 4 years old to 7 years old, so that's like pre-K, kindergarten, first grade, that kind of age range, you can come to camp with a special adult. So maybe that's your mom, your dad, grandma, grandpa, your favorite aunt or uncle. So you can come with them and come for a weekend and do all kinds of awesome camp stuff, but you get to bring your special adult. So that's super fun. If you are in first through third grade, you can come for a few days. So it's not a whole week, but a few days. You can come by yourself or bring a friend, and you get to do all kinds of cool camp stuff too, like archery and swimming and canoeing and awesome stuff. If you are third through eighth grade, so most of you here, you guys have two programs. There's Pathfinder and Trailblazer. One is just for younger kids, one is just for older. So that is a weekend camp, Sunday to Friday. You do all the camp stuff. So you do canoeing, archery, the things I mentioned before, but also you're there for longer, so you get to do more things. Games on the athletic field, you saw lots of them in the video. And then if you are 7th and 8th grade, that's awesome. Like, camp opens up to you then. And you could do Pathfinder Trailblazer, but you can also do Quest, which is a week long. You spend your nights at camp, but each day you go off-site and do some other adventure. So maybe it's exploring waterfalls, maybe it's biking, maybe it's canoeing, whatever. But you go off and you have an awesome adventure. 8th grade is when our Impact program starts. And so Impact is our longest program. So it's Friday to Friday, longest program, and it focuses on service and leadership. So you're gonna do some off-site adventure stuff. It's gonna be awesome. You're also gonna really learn what it means to be a servant leader like Jesus was. And so we would love to have you at camp this summer. What is going to happen, or what does happen, is people who love camp, they give money to this program called Every Kid to Camp. And so Every Kid to Camp, again, people who love camp and they want every kid to come to camp, they donate money, and then we are able to give camp to someone who has never been to camp before. So what's gonna happen is that sometime in the next couple of days here, you're gonna get a slip of paper that you can take home, and if you've never been to camp before, your parents can sign that, you'll go in a drawing, and we're gonna draw two names, so two of you will be able to come to camp this summer at no cost to your family. So someone else is paying for you to come to camp because they love camp so much and they know that you're going to love it. So look for that in the next couple of days. We would love to see you at camp this summer. One last thing is last word. So we start our days at camp with first word. Towards the end of the day, we have last word. And so our last word today is also from the book of Philippians. And it says, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your requests to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Thank you again for having me today. I love coming to chapels and hanging out with you guys. And I would love to see you this summer. You'll be getting brochures to take home. And remember, if you've never been to camp before, you could have a chance to come at no cost to your family. So be looking for that too. Thank you guys so much and have a great day.
Thank you. Any special announcements? Offerings this month are going
to. So this month, chapel offerings are going to the Aruba Mission. They are working to go into school in Cambodia.
And this is called Hearts for Jesus, and Hearts for Jesus is being done throughout the North Wisconsin District. So all of our schools in the North Wisconsin District, all 21, are helping support that mission. Have a blessed day, Lord.